Welcome back to a brand new series, Anatomy Dissected by Complete Anatomy. Continuing on with our cranial nerve series, it's now time to take a look at the second cranial nerve, the optic nerve. In this video, we'll first outline the course of this nerve, explore briefly the visual pathway, and then finish off by looking at some of the clinical correlates associated with this nerve. The optic nerve is responsible for the perception of vision. The journey of the optic nerve begins at the retina, where it is formed by the convergence of axons from the retinal ganglion cells. These cells in turn receive impulses from the photoreceptors of the eye, known as the rods and cones. After its formation, the optic nerve leaves the bony orbit via the optic canal, a passageway through the sphenoid bone. It enters the cranial cavity, running through the chiasmatic sulcus in close proximity to the pituitary gland. Within the middle cranial fossa, the optic nerves from each eye unite to form the optic chiasm. The optic chiasm then continues on to form the optic tract. Each optic tract travels to the ipsilateral cerebral hemisphere via the lateral geniculate nucleus, and more of this will be described in the visual pathway. The visual pathway consists of a series of cells and synapses that carry visual information from the environment to the brain for processing. In this image, the visual fields are illustrated in front of each eyeball. A representation of the retina is illustrated behind the eye, and we've been introduced to the optic chiasm and the optic tract previously. The visual field of each eye is divided into nasal and temporal halves. The retina of each eye has two parts, a temporal part and a nasal part. Information from the visual field is perceived in the opposite side of the retina. For example, looking at the left eye, information from the temporal visual field is perceived in the nasal half of the retina. Information from the nasal visual field is perceived in the temporal half of the retina. The same rules apply to the right eye. As we've said before, information travels from the retina through the optic nerve to the optic chiasm. At the optic chiasm, fibers from the nasal half of each retina cross over to the opposite side. Fibers from the temporal halves remain on the same side. A combination of fibers from the nasal and temporal halves of each retina forms the optic tract. The optic tract carries nerve fibers to the lateral geniculate nucleus, a relay system located in the thalamus. Here, the fibers synapse. Axons from the lateral geniculate nucleus then carry visual information via a pathway known as the optic radiation to reach the visual cortex in the occipital lobe of the cerebral hemisphere. Once at the visual cortex, the brain processes the sensory data and responds appropriately. Now, let's have a look at some of the clinical correlates. Visual pathway abnormalities may occur as a result of trauma to the head, ischemia from loss of vascular supply, and compression from cranial tumors. Damage to the optic nerve can lead to loss of vision to the affected eye. This is known as monocular blindness. Compression of the optic chiasm is most commonly caused by an enlargement of the pituitary gland from a pituitary adenoma and can lead to loss of vision in the temporal fields. This is known as bitemporal hemianopia. Damage to the optic tract leads to visual field loss on the same side of both eyes. This is known as homonymous hemianopia. Great, that's it. You should now be able to describe the origin of the optic nerve and its course through the middle cranial fossa. Describe the components of the visual pathway and describe the effects of damage to the visual pathway. So that's a wrap. Stay tuned for the rest of our series on the cranial nerves. And be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more top-class anatomy content.